Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did in equation which was based on ideal gas equation, and related to that we are now going to do a numerical which is based on ideal gas equation. So let us do it. So as on your screen, it is a numerical which is based on the ideal gas equation. So first of all, let us analyze what is the question asking about. So therefore, it has been given that a gas occupies a volume of 0.3 dm cube at 290 Kelvin, and the pressure is said to be, that is 92.458 kilo Newton per meter square. So let me tell you, this is nothing related to Kelvin, because they are relating it with pressure, and pressure has its own unit which is which has nothing related to that for the Kelvin or temperature. So therefore, this K, which is a small alphabet, is nothing but the kilo. So this is the thing that we should be aware of while doing the numerical. So that makes the numerical much more interesting. So now we have to calculate the volume of gas at STP. So now the thing is, they have provided us this one volume, that is, the next is temperature, and this is the pressure that they have provided to us. And let us see how can we solve this thing. So the data that we have, so the given data, they have given me only one condition, and in that one condition, what they have provided us is that they have provided us the volume, which is 0.3 dm cube, as well as they have provided the temperature as T is equals to, that is, 290 Kelvin. And yes, the one more thing that they have given to us is pressure, which is basically 92.458 kilo Newton per meter square, or I could say it as Pascal. So this is what they have given to us, and by giving this thing, they are asking that we have to calculate it, calculate the volume of the gas at STP. So basically, they are giving us two conditions. The one condition is which is given here, and the next condition is they are providing us STP, and another condition which is having standard temperature and pressure. So therefore, this V, T and P is nothing but V1, T1 and P1. We could relate this thing as V1, T1 and P1. And one more thing, this has been given in Pascal, and they have also related with kilo, that is KPa. So therefore, I could write it as, that is, 92.458 into 10 raised to 3 Pascal. And the thing is, they have again provided a STP condition. So therefore, in STP condition, I would write here also. But the thing is, they have provided me Pascal, that is Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. So in that case, what is comes in your mind is Newton per meter, somewhere related to meter. But the thing that they have given to us is, we see, decimeter. So therefore, we could convert this into a cubic meter also. So for that, what I will do is, I will multiply 0.3 into 10 raised to minus 3. Now it has been converted into cubic meter. So this is the first condition that they have given to us, and we have to write for the second condition. But for second condition, they are asking me what will be the value of V2. And in this case, they are saying, they have given me the temperature, because in STP, the temperature is nothing but 273.15 Kelvin. And while talking about the pressure, that is P, this will be V2, this temperature will be T2, and this pressure, that is STP, the pressure at STP. So the pressure at STP is nothing but basically 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square, or we could write it as Pascal. So this is the two conditions that we have got, that is one for STP and one for the normal condition what they have provided to us. So in this case, these are the two things that we have got. And related to that, we have to calculate what will be the value of V2. So let us do it. How can we calculate this thing? So for that, we know that according to ideal gas equation, basically PV is equals to nRT, this is what we know. But they have given us pressure, volume and temperature. So for that thing, what I could do, because the number of moles of the gas will be constant, as well as the gas constant is itself a constant value, having a constant value. So the thing that is varying is basically P, V and T. So I could relate this thing as PV divided by T is nothing but will be a constant value, which is related to N into R. So now they have given us two conditions. So I could write it as P1 V1 divided by T1 is equals to P2 V2 divided by T2. So this condition or this formula is nothing for the ideal gas equation itself, but this is the combining gas equation that we have got P1 V1 and T1 as well as P2, V2 and T2. So now let us come back to the main thing, that is the P1 that they have provided to us is basically, I'm going to substitute the values here and let us see what is the answer that we could get. So in this case, what they have provided us the value of P1 as, basically they have given us 92.458 into 10 raised to 3 Pascal, which is multiplied by V1, the value of V1, which was found to be basically 0.3 into 10 raised to minus 3 cubic meter, or I could say it as meter cube, the whole divided by basically the temperature, which was given to us as 290 Kelvin. And now for the next one, that is for P2. So in the P2 value has, that is 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal, which is multiplied by V2, that is something which we have to calculate, and divided by T2, and the T2 basically the second temperature, that is 273.15. So this is the thing that we have to calculate. And now the thing is, this 10 raised to 3 and this 10 raised to minus 3, they both will cancel out each other. Okay, and from this thing we have to calculate V2. So I'm arranging the value of V2 as, so therefore the value of V2 can be written as basically 92.458 into 0.3 into 273.15, and yes, and the whole will be divided by basically 290 into 1.013 into 10 raised to 5. So let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got a value of 2.57 into 10 raised to minus 4 cubic meter, that is cubic meter. So I could convert this into this is the final volume that we have got, basically the volume of at a particular condition, that is at STP. So I could convert into dm cube also, so it would be very much easy to calculate in that thing. So therefore 2.57 into 10 raised to minus 4, so this has been given in cubic meter, so I could convert it into dm cube also by multiplying it by 10 raised to 3 basically. So now this would give us the answer as 0.257, and the overall answer would be in dm cube. So this is the value that we have got. So it was a very much related to ideal gas equation. I hope you have understood how to solve this kind of numerical. So yes, share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.